Mesela Karl Marx'ın Mason olduğunu birçok kişi bilmez. Lenin'in Mason olduğunu birçok kişi bilmez. Mesela Hitler'in Masonluğa hayranlığını ve Masonlukla bağını kimse bilmez. Aynı şekilde Mussolini'nin de
For example,
Masonlukla
many
bağını kimse
people are
bilmez.
unaware that
Mesela
Karl Marx was a
Mussolini'nin
Mason.
Mayonist olduğunu kimse bilmez.
Many people do not know that Lenin was a Mason.
Mason boş zannediyorlar.
Nobody
Boş
knows
değil.
about Hitler's admiration for
Fransızların
and devotion to Freemasonry. Neither do people know about
Masonlar.
Mussolini's link to Freemasonry.
Adamlar
Nobody
olarak
knows what lodges they were registered
Fransız
with.
o kadar gözü
They
dönmüş.
imagine these
O
people
kadar
acted
karanlık bir geçmiş
independently,
vardır Masonların.
but they did not. Those who ushered in the French Revolution were Masons. The Masons even executed their own people during the French Revolution. That is how fanatical they are. That is the kind of evil organization Freemasonry is. It grips the world like an octopus. As a Muslim, I cannot ignore that organization. Because Freemasonry is aimed against Muslims, it regards Islam as the number one danger facing it, and it particularly targets those who serve Islam. That is why Freemasonry has targeted me. Not just me, but all Muslim leaders, but it also targeted me. I have been in a struggle against them for years. The reason for Freemasonry's success, its evil success, is that it is secret. Muslims fight bravely in the open, but nobody is aware of the Masons' presence as they have fought cowardly. They are invisible, and since they can crop up anywhere, it is difficult to combat them. But Freemasonry is still a failure. Power in America is generally in the hands of Masons. That has been the case ever since America was founded. The government has been in the hands of the Masons ever since the country was first founded. There has never been a truly independent administration. Freemasonry has always persecuted any movement opposed to it. They assassinated Kennedy, for example, because he was against the Masons. Therefore, there will be no change in American policy just because of a change of government. The important thing is for the American public to be liberated from Masonic domination. We, for instance, are engaged in very formidable activities against Darwinism in America. The level of people of believing in Darwinism used to be very high in America, but that has now fallen enormously. There are currently very few believers in Darwinism, but there has been a huge rise in the numbers of believers in Allah. And that happened in the wake of our activities in America. That also applies to Turkey, where 50% to 60% of people used to believe in Darwinism, though the figure has now dropped to around 10%. By the will of Allah, our achievement in that fall to a level of 10% is plain for all to see. Because there is nobody apart from us engaged in such activities, there are no other groups actively striving against Darwinism. Nobody is so influential, so effective, or acts so rationally as us. We are the only ones. The Masons, the largest Masonic temples, are in America and Britain, but most powerfully they originate from Britain and Ireland. They have historic, ancient temples, and there is one in Jerusalem, a temple in Jerusalem. They call them lodges, but they are really temples. For example, September 11 is something that was entirely organized by Freemasonry. The public are unaware of the facts behind September 11. 3 to 5 terrorists boarded a plane, it struck and that, they imagined, was that. Not so. These things were the result of very complex and fine planning. They say that terror began in Afghanistan or somewhere else. These things are organized under Masonic control. Freemasonry and atheist Zionism have 100, 200, and 300-year plans organized by Satan, and they implement them with the greatest care.